Today we're going to talk about the Rumba board with the REPRAP discount full graphics smart controller. So I need to point out a couple of things here. These are our EXP ports. So we have one and two. Now in front of them there's a little black mark. That has to do with the notch connector that we're going to use for the ribbon cables to connect to the LCD. So in a moment, I'll show you a little bit more about the LCD, and then I'll show you how to connect it. So here's the LCD. I'm going to point out the obvious to everyone. We have our screen, then we have our piezo buzzer down below, then we have two reset buttons located down below, and then a knob to navigate back and forth with a little bit of pressure you can select. On the back side, we have a SD card reader, and then we also have our EXP2 and our EXP1. So to connect the EXP1 and 2, you're going to use a notched connector and you're going to place it in and press it down. So we're going to do the same for EXP1. And now the trick to connecting this is on the Rumba board, they're reversed. So in a second, I'll show you how to connect these to the Rumba board. Okay, starting with EXP2, I'm going to connect it with the notch side up to EXP1. And then I'm going to do the exact same thing for EXP1 to EXP2 on the Rumba board. Then I'm going to rotate this over so you can see it. And in a moment, I'll show you how to load the Marlin firmware. Okay, before we can load the Marlin firmware, we're going to connect the USB serial cable. And we're going to connect it to the computer, so you're going to hear a beep. And in a moment, we'll load the Marlin firmware. Okay, the first thing that we want to do is we want to select marlin-bugfix-1.1.9. We then want to select the Marlin subfolder. And then we want to open up the boards.h file. And what we're searching for in here is our board_Rumba. So we're going to copy that. Then we're going to close out of this. We're going to hit M on the keyboard. And we're going to open up marlin.ino. Now we want to select the configuration.h tab. And we want to do a search on motherboard. And we want to replace board_ramps_14_EFB with what we just copied. So we're going to paste it here. So it'll be board_Rumba. Next thing we want to do is look for SD support. And we're going to scroll down and look around a little bit here. First thing I want to point out is that the LCD default language is English, but if you want to change it, you can obviously change it to things like French. You could also do German, Italian, or various other languages like Polish. And then down below, there's different character-based settings that you can do for the LCD, such as Japanese, Western, or Cyrillic. Over here, currently the SD card is not enabled, but if you backspace and remove the comments, you can use it, but currently we're not interested in that. Spy support I'm not going to talk about because it's not on this particular LCD. If you're having trouble loading on your SD card, you can always remove the comments here. It'll check and retry. And then of course you have different types of menu support that you could use. Obviously, there's different encoders or potentiometers to change menus. So that basically covers most of what you need to know for now. I mean, you can play with these settings on your own time. but I want to show you how to load the actual firmware with the particular LCD. So we're going to do a find on discount full. That's discount underscore full. And what we have here is REPRAP discount full graphics smart controller. So we need to remove the comments in front to enable it. And keep in mind with this particular LCD, you have to load the U8 glib or the graphical library. And do that, one of the ways you can do this is going to Tools, Manage Libraries, and when this comes up, it'll take about 30 seconds. You'll type in U8 glib, and it's the very last thing that comes up in the search. And all you have to do is press Install. But for now, to keep this short, I'm going to show you how to load the Marlin firmware so that we can then test the LCD. So we're going to select the Mega 2560 because that's our processor. And then we're also going to check COM port 7 so that we can actually load to it. So we're going to use the upload button. So this will compile and then upload. And in a moment, I'll show you how to test the LCD. Okay, to test this, I'm going to connect the USB to show you that we've actually set it up. So right now it's just powering up. Then it'll show a splash screen. And then finally, it'll show you the regular printer status as it knows it. And so if you want to enter a menu, you can always push down and then scroll through the menus. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe, and thank you for your time.